A great place for families, easy access to the city of Chicago, excellent schools, and a vibrant downtown. In this video, I cover everything you need to know about living in Downers Grove, Illinois. So stay tuned. What's happening, everybody? This is Austin Weiss, your go-to home advisor right here in the Chicagoland area. If you're brand new or returning to my channel, make sure to smash that subscribe button and tap that bell so you don't miss out on any of my future videos. I do a ton of content all about what it's like to work, eat, live, and play right here in the Chicago metro. And I have so many people reaching out to me from watching my videos regarding their move here in the Chicagoland area. So if you are thinking about making a move, you can always reach me by phone, text, email, days, nights, weekends, and I would absolutely love to have a conversation with you and help simplify that whole process. Okay, so you're doing a ton of research on your own, trying to figure out where to live and finding that perfect spot for yourself and your family to move to in the Chicago metro. Well, I came up with the things to know when considering moving to Downers Grove, Illinois, and these are frequently asked questions that I've received and research that I've done on my own that I think they're the 9 to 10 things that you really should consider and know before moving to Downers Grove, Illinois. And make sure you watch until the very end, because the last one I talk about is actually the most frequently asked question I receive, at least from people moving here from out of state. So without any further ado, let's hop right into number one, and that's the centralized location that Downers Grove sits on. Right here in the western suburbs of Chicago, it's a fantastic centralized location with 3 metro stops and easy highway access to I-355 and I-88. Downers Grove sits just 22 miles west of downtown Chicago, just south of Oak Brook's shopping and business districts as well, which has some fantastic nightlife, restaurants, and things to do. And it also has easy access to other downtown areas and neighboring suburbs, which takes us right into number 2, which is the employment and easy commuting times. So because of its centralized location, this really is a commuter's paradise and makes it a highly desirable place for people to call home. With the business district in the north end of Downers Grove, just off of I-88 and Butterfield Road, it features numerous mid-rises and home to corporate and regional headquarters, including Ambitec, Dover, and Pepperidge Farms. Number 3, the vibrant downtown of Downers Grove. It actually made my top 10 best downtowns in the Chicago suburbs list. You can watch that whole video right here. Just click the link. It's Main Street with its cute boutiques, cafes, and community events. It has quickly become a shopping and dining destination due to its location and variety, with plenty of free parking. It has authentic restaurants such as Bar Cheeto, Gia Mia, and Caribbean Corner, and craft beer and wine at Emmett's Brewery and the Cellar Door Bistro and Wine Shop just off of Main Street. Throughout the year, the downtown area of Downers Grove features numerous festivals with live music, local food, kids' activities, and of course, some adult beverages. One of my favorites is the Downers Grove Grove Festival in the summer. It has the car show, local food and craft beer, carnival rides, and live music. The fall features Harvest Fest, and in the winter, they had the Winter Ice Festival that features over 40 different ice sculptures up and down Main Street. And on Thanksgiving morning, I loved to participate in the turkey trot because it makes me feel less guilty when I go and shove my face with a bunch of food and turkey later in the day. That takes us right into number 5, things to do because you want to enjoy your life and have fun, because that's what it's all about. So Downers Grove has the Downers Grove Golf Club. It's actually the first 9-hole course west of the Appalachians. There's the historic Tivoli Theater, so if you're a movie buff like me, go grab some popcorn at Tivoli and catch a flick. They also have the Downers Grove Swim and Racquet Club, which is a great way to meet people, play some tennis, and sign those kids up for a swim team. Also have Lyman Woods Forest Preserve. It's 150 acres of wildlife, including this guy I ran into last fall shooting some vlog footage, and also Fish Hole Park featuring Veterans Memorial Pavilion. It's used for the Summer Family Concert Series and special events, located right downtown Downers Grove. Moving on to number 6, and if you love being outdoors like I do, Downers Grove has some fantastic parks and recreation facilities. They actually have 69 different parks covering 600 acres of park and forest preserve space. Some of my favorites include McCollum Park. It has some phenomenal athletic facilities, a walking path surrounding the entire park, and a putt-putt course. They have Barth Pond at Patriots Park. It's beautiful, relaxing, and plenty of fishing. Hidden Lake Forest Preserve in the northwest corner, you can kayak there, get some fishing done. There's plenty of trails and barbecue pavilions. And then Downers Grove has been named a Tree City 28 times by the National Arbor Day Foundation, so there's plenty of greenery, and in the fall, It's absolutely stunning when the leaves change. If you love to get your fit on, work out like I do, Downers Grove Rec Center and Good Samaritan Wellness Center are the go-to spots. The Good Samaritan Wellness Center is directly next to Good Sam Hospital. Number 7 takes us into housing, and I'm sure if you're watching this video about Downers Grove, you want to know about the neighborhoods and the housing. So Downers Grove has roughly about 50,000 people for a population. It's more of a medium-sized Chicago suburb, and the median price point for a single-family detached home is roughly $440,000. There's beautiful neighborhoods throughout, mixing with the new construction with historical homes. The areas surrounding downtown are some of my favorites because of the aesthetic and location, and one of the largest concentration of existing Sears Roebuck homes and American Foursquare homes can be found just north of downtown Downers Grove. If you want to know more about the specific neighborhoods, price points, style of homes, you can definitely watch my vlog video all about Downers Grove right here. Going off of housing is number 8, the schools and school districts of Downers Grove. Essentially what you need to know is there's two different school districts, grade school district number 58 and the high school district number 99. Both districts combined service just under 10,000 students at a student to teacher ratio of 16-1. Most of the grade schools are walking distance right in the neighborhood, so you can walk the kiddos to school in the morning and pick them up in the afternoon. And the town is essentially split in half between Downers Grove North High School on the north end of town and Downers Grove South High School on the south end of town. If you want to know more about the top Chicago suburb school districts, I did an entire video about this a few months ago, which you can watch, and I will link it down in the description box below. Last but certainly not least is number 9. What's going on with the weather there in Downers Grove and the Chicagoland area? This is probably the number one question I receive from people moving here from a warmer climate or from out of state. So 8 months of the year, the temperatures and the weather is phenomenal. Fall brings cool temps with vibrant colors on the trees. Summer, there's always lots to do and everybody loves being outdoors. Spring is always welcome after the long winter, and beautiful colors popping up all around Downers Grove. The worst months are probably January and February. That's the coldest, the snowiest, and the darkest. So if you can hop out of town for a week or two, I definitely recommend doing so. The kids love it, however, because we do get the most snow after the new year. They make snow forts, go sledding, and of course the snowball fights, which I loved to do when I was a kid. Another frequently asked question from I receive is, how quickly do the roads get cleared? And every town, including Downers Grove and the Chicagoland area, is well equipped to clear snow quickly and efficiently. So between the plows and the salt trucks, pretty much they're going all night long so that you can get to work in the morning and the kids can hop on the bus or walk to school the next day, no problem. But if you have any questions about any of these topics, or if you are considering making a move anywhere in the Chicagoland area or Downers Grove, you can always reach out to me by phone, text, email, days, nights, weekends, and I would love for the opportunity to help you in any way possible. But until next time, I'll catch you guys later.